In last 6 months, I spent $1,000 on 3D AI tools and I've got really disappointed. Or not. Hey guys, this is Steph and today we're not gonna test any of AI tool. In fact, actually, this will be my honest thinking about the current state of all these AI tools. Are they worth it? Because I spent quite a penny on all these tools and some of them are quite expensive and there are a lot of downsides. So I try to break it down step by step based on my experience, how good it is, how you can use it, how you can benefit from it, and what you should definitely avoid. Okay, so the first thing I want to start with is the use case. So what we see around is cherry-picked examples, right? That you can basically create anything. You can use AI tools, create objects, use it whenever, like in games, in video rendering, like I mean anything, anywhere, and it's very easy and it's very accurate and precise. But in reality, in my opinion, it is far, far from the production readiness. It is really good for ideation, for concept creation, and for that small areas where creative Gen AI will work. So let's quickly go through it. Ideation. It's good to create ideas. Absolutely yes. I mean, you can create images, you can create some basic 3D models, etc., and see like if it's the right direction. But you might be in a position when you have something in mind and it looks like you can create it with AI, like you can create an image and then create a 3D model, but that specific details that you want is just not there. Like, and production cases where we actually get money from it is like we need to do 3D models of exact products, right? And there is no option to actually fail in reflecting something. If there is a screw here, then it should be here exactly, right? It's very important for many products. So to round it up about use cases, again, AI is a boost in the very beginning to start creating, to just make this first step, like ideation concepts, add some creativity. That's fine. But when we move to production, with precision, consistency is important. This is absolutely no-no. Another interesting use case that still very valid, and I saw many examples actually based on it, is that you can use it as a props creation tool, right? For some videos, for backgrounds, for some scenes, for some games, etc. But this is a narrow use case where creativity and consistency is actually not a problem. Like, we just need a tree or a lemon or a banana, right? And we just need that props somewhere there, like, and again, like, it will be in a background or it's like somewhere in the game, like we work around, like, that's fine. And some tools with four textures can adjust it. That's cool. The second thing I want to raise is generation consistency. It is a huge problem and you really don't know what to expect in many cases. Like, I was tested like many AI tools. So for example, there is Rodin, that one of my favorites so far. In some cases, I load some images and it actually gives me really nice result. Like, and I was like, wow, okay, this is like a video material. The moment I actually replicate this process on camera, it gives me absolutely terrible result from the very same input. This is something you cannot control, right? It's just random. Sometimes it predicted good, sometimes it predicted bad. And consistency couldn't be a problem, right? If it's not cost you quite a lot, right? And that's why, like, in good models such as Rodin, still they do have like 20 iterations, etc., but that might be not enough, like, to actually get that good 3D models. But even though we have options to regenerate for free, guys, it might take hours to regenerate. So let's say we have 20 retry to generate it, and again, like, each retry will take like few minutes. If it's Hunyuan model, like, it might take like 7-14 minutes. The bright side of it is that everyone is aware about it, and this is basically main challenge right now to achieve that consistency. And now that's why, like, for image models, there are like LoRAs, there's a lot of control nets, etc., and it's improving, but at this point still this is a problem. Number three, and this is something that you might face if you take this 3D AI tool seriously, such as myself, right? About service stability. Most of best models are online tools and you access them either via API or by online platform. And the moment you might need it, because let's say you're working hours, like 8 hours, like within a day, the service might simply not work. They might be rolling up updates, and with AI, they're rolling up updates all the time. They might be changing something, updating something. It might be just simply crowded day, right? And I'm not using these tools every day, but still I'm facing this situation many, many times. Guys, comment down below if you also face it yourself in situations like this. And this makes these tools like quite unreliable. And again, guys, this is really often right now. But to be honest, if you using things like ComfyUI, we'll talk about this one a bit more, then you are not really dependent and you can run it on your device, right, on your hardware, and then you pretty much abstract it from availability of the services, etc., which is pretty much solvable. But again, like, you cannot run Rodin on your local machine, right? So far the best one is Hunyuan 2.1. probably I don't see a real competitor right now for it. Before we continue, guys, here is Mr. Mug. And he is a producer of my channel, guys, and he is kindly asking you to subscribe and like so we can create more videos and he can buy a new hat. Thanks. And number four is about, is it actually faster to do it with AI or do it manually? So I would say skilled 3D artists in most of the cases still will outperform 3D AI tool, because the amount of time you spend to finalize the models, if we talk about production level again, like, is almost the same. Sometimes it's equal as if you do it from scratch, but in case of generation, like, you also need to spend that money on generation and time, which is probably more valuable than money, right? So you need to create something, then you need to polish it, and you need to recreate it. Well, if this is a relatively simple object, there's a lot of tools and software that help 3D artists create it from scratch very fast. So I'm not taking into account AI tools that helps in manual process, like photo projection, like texturing tools, etc. That's a little bit different. I'm talking about creating it with AI tool. And this is actually a very unobvious trap that can cost you a lot of time, because FOMO is very strong here, right? But in reality, sometimes we just get it done like manually, like in a solid quality and faster and cheaper. But it's still something I need to mention. There is a big progress in topology, in texturing and so on that might really help. And in right hands, it can actually boost the performance, not only on ideation stage, but in execution stage. So the recently Hunyuan, they announced like a tool that actually do a right topology on existing 3D models. Like, it can be AI model, it can be like your model, and it actually do a right topology. This is actually very useful, right? Texturing tool, even though they are unstable, but with right combinations, like, I really like the combo when you just take your object, you put it like in flex context, right? That keeps the original object as a texture on top, and you bring it here, like, you put the image and 3D model, and it actually create a really great foundation for texturing. In some cases, that actually it can do like 90% of work, right? There's even a tool like 3D AI Studio and Common Sense Machine. They do have tool where you can up paint it like on a projection. For 3D artists, that's basically nothing, because they can do the same thing. Those tools are really breakthrough, right? So I really like that AI texturing, like Boss, where you paint it on top, where you generate texture, or they do topology, because this is actual value right now, right? It really saves time, it's really speed up the process. So take that into account. And number five, let's talk about pricing. Even though it looks like each platform like gives us a lot of credits, a lot of options, etc., etc., it costs a lot on long distance, right? And when we talk about real production and we start like, okay, like, you got a job, you got a task, and you need to create something, and it's like, it's not perfect, like, you need to adjust, like, you do one more time, and the money is just like, they just disappear. In reality, there is no really all-in-one tool. Let's say I need really good geometry, there's like probably top one is like Spark. They just do geometry, like, best of a kind right now, right? Okay, there is Ivo 3D, like, they do 4K textures. Well, that's the only thing they do, really. Geometry there, well, I would dare say that is like on a decent level, like, for some objects, yes, but for textures, they do outstanding quality, right? There is tools that do both on a good level for some objects, and again, like, and we end up like that we need 3-4 subscriptions, and we all constantly need to buy up credits, etc. And well, this is how I actually spent like thousands of dollars, actually, for all these subscriptions, credits, etc., to record these videos and so on. But the interesting thing that one of the best 3D AI model that is out there right now and which can actually eliminate most of the problems I mentioned is free. Hunyuan 2.1 or Hunyuan 2.0 that are available via Confi setup that you can use even on a low VRAM GPUs. I tested on my own like 12 gigabytes and it was performing very, very nice. There are amazing flows like MV adapter that actually allows you to texture it, and you can run it for free for real tasks that it can do. That's more than enough. Geometry is fine. In high 3D, in Confi UI, you can control poly count, you can unwrap it using XAtlas, like you can texture it like with MV adapter, etc. Again, like that's for free. That's the paradox, like basically one of the best tools that we can get right now for real tasks, ideation, concepts, texturing are for free. Okay, so with all that said, what is the future here? So it is true that these things evolves very quickly, and I believe like most of the problems will be eliminated like in a year or two or even faster, because most of them is already addressed. But let's not be delusional on this stage that in my opinion is still in early stage. We're still understanding like how to use this tool correctly, but one thing for sure, you absolutely cannot ignore that this is coming and you need to be aware about what's happening, like how good it is, etc. In the moment it happened, I want you to be first to be aware of it and implement it in your app, in your routine, and benefit from it. But right now, let's be rational. And as a very last thought, I want to mention that 3D AI as polygonal 3D is not the only one thing. There are some promising technologies like a photogrammetry that improves every time that result in 3D models based on actual reality, right? There is Gaussian splatting that actually shows amazing, stunning results. There is more and more support of some game engines like VR engines like that supports that Gaussian splatting inside. The big difference there is that while Gen AI actually predicts or like fantasize, then photogrammetry is more like to actually reflect what it is with adding depth. That's why splats and photogrammetry looks so much better, like, and so much accurate, even though there's artifacts of a different kind, but still. But even though I'm done with this, guys, I will still keep you updated on what's new, what's worth it, and you'll be the first to know about it. See you in the next video.